Former APD officer claims his wife killed herself with his service weapon, but the gun has no fingerprints.
Today, on day 15 of the Levi Chavez trial, the jury saw for themselves how Tera Chavez's blood proved one of the state's theories.
From the start of the Levi Chavez murder trial, the state has pointed out an inconsistency with the defense's theory of suicide. Prosecutors say the magazine clip had been released after Tera Chavez was shot in the mouth, something an OMI expert says Tera could not physically do because her brainstem was severed.
Someone had to press that magazine release after it was fired.
Firearms expert Mark Radosevich brought the weapon over to the jury and explained how that works. He told them that he couldn't really tell by the crime scene pictures alone if the gun was really found like that. In person, however, he knew it was.
When I depress the magazine release so that it is released, I can see the stain, the full stain.
A stain made by Tara's own blood on the part of the magazine clip that had been released and exposed as she was dying. But there was more than just an unseated magazine clip. The jury learned the gun that Chavez claims Tara used to kill herself had no fingerprints.
Were you ever able to find any usable prints?
No, I was not.
Prosecutors say Chavez used his police training to stage the scene and not get caught. Chavez has told investigators he left his APD-issued Glock with Tara for her own protection while he carried a different gun on duty. Tara's twin brother, the state's final witness, left the jury with this last thought. She hated guns.
Anytime they come up in conversation, or even if she was around them or near them at all, she never liked them.
In Sandoval County, Ana Velasquez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The defense begins its case tomorrow. We're also tracking another huge development in the Chavez case. His former APD partner will testify, and he has full immunity. You don't want to miss that story coming up later in our newscast.